Thanks, John. I'm joined now by Dr. Keisha Hayward from Falls Road Animal Hospital, along with Chloe. You have to look at this face. Look at that face. She is so cute. Golden Retriever.
Oh, she's a lab.
Oh, she's a lab. She's a yellow lab.
Yes, they look very similar.
See, I know my breeds, don't I? No, she's gorgeous. How about a few questions? We've got three of them to get to. We'll start with Peg. She writes, we have a 10-year-old coonhound mix. He's a gentle dog, but hates going to the vet. A new vet suggested anesthetizing him to do blood work and clean his teeth. Would you recommend this for a dog his age, or is he already so traumatized by going to the vet? Something else.
Yeah, a lot of dogs are really nervous about going to the vet, and it's a new situation, so you can understand that. But the important thing to remember is that we don't want to skip out on their health because we know they're nervous, and sedation is a great way to get around that. If you're sedating them and they can feel a little bit more calm while they're there, then you can end up getting everything done in one fell swoop, and dental health's really important. So if your vet's recommending it, he's seeing something that's concerning him. So.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. I was recently told by a pet trainer that there are certain types of grass that dogs like to graze on this time of year, and that those grasses won't make dogs sick. Is it just a myth that eating grass will make dogs throw up?
It's not that grass is poisonous or that it causes stomach upset, really. A lot of dogs will eat grass when they feel a little bit nauseous because it does help them kind of purge their stomach. So, like, it's one of those things that if your dog eats grass and it makes him vomit, then he's one of those dogs, and I'd probably just stay away from
it. So it just depends on the dog.
Yeah.
Got a question from Sean. He says, my black and yellow labs dig constantly in our backyard. Is there something I'm missing? Do you dig, Chloe? Is that what you're telling me?
Chloe's going to like
What's
digging when she gets
with,
a little bigger.
With labs and digging in the backyard?
Well, it's certainly not just labs. A lot of dogs like to dig, and it's something that's a pretty natural thing for them. So if you really, really don't want your dog to dig, then it's something you need to train them to have another activity that's fun in the yard.
Okay.
So when they're out there, they're going to go and they're going to find the most fun thing they can do and do it. And if digging's that's what they're going to pick. And
okay.
I mean, while we're talking about being outside, like, this is the time of year we really want to be worried about fleas and ticks and that kind of thing. So it's important to go ahead and make sure you talk to your vet about what products would be a good thing to have them on to prevent that, because we don't want them to come in from digging and bring special friends in.
Good advice. Chloe, your time's up. You did beautifully. Yeah, we'll let you go now, sweetheart.
I think she has something to say.
Appreciate your time, doctor.